Well, hello everybody, welcome back to episode 313 of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity! I'm Avatopia. Alright then, we believe we are on the right track for hers. I believe it's in this corner. Because it's with cliffs and stuff, and looking at the map, I was like, I haven't brought her with me. And nothing stands out as cliffs. So I'm thinking, like, if I was playing it properly, well, I'll say I'm playing it properly, but what I'm saying is she was with me as part of my main six group. When we travelled here, any clues would have just popped up. But with her not being with us, we're missing these clues. And that means I've got to go to every single place until she drops a clue. So I googled, and it told me Pearl Bluff. And I thought, oh, I didn't even see that there. But apparently, I hadn't even been there before, because it was all black. But it said it's southwest and elemental, so down here. Oh, she's been attacked. But I want to discover this first. Apparently attacked. Oh, that's something. Does she even have it? No AI script, of course. 1 second! That's at least should have similar Tiffies. Oh, you have none too? Oh, okay. Cautious, aggressive, aggressive. No, wrong button. Fudgy mudgy. Cautious, aggressive, aggressive. Boom, boom. Go. How do your things differ? You have a skull. You have the takedown ability that she doesn't. You have a wound binding that Tiffy doesn't. Give blood to Tiffy.
Yeah. My book.
There we go. So I said we're trying to pass all the side quests or get as far in them as we can before we push the main quest. We're basically stuck with the main quest right now until we push through it. And we also have the White March 2 to finish off, so we're also trying to level up for that too. Assuming that would just take me to one of these. I didn't realize I'd never been here. Holy shug! I wasn't expecting them dragons. Or young drakes. And a regular drake. Time to convert ourselves. We've been moving or something? Like, why not move it? Oh my god. Oh. Trouble right now. Oh no, we're fine. We're fine. Right in. We're okay. We're okay. It's a little dragon attack. We're fine. Can you guys heal before we get attacked again? Nope. In the bay below, waves roll toward Defiance Bay. Hello, elementals. This is what they talked about.
Just say the word, yeah?
You're mine.
There we go. Beautiful. So I should be down here then. It's a really small map. Oh. I went for that, didn't I? I didn't pick it up in the end. No!
Just say the word.
Nothing? That's this. Or that. That's that. Oh, what the hell? Breeze ruffles your clothes as you approach the edge of the bluff. Cave mouth yawns from the cliff face, it only a dozen feet below your position. But the weathered rock is too smooth to scale. A rock pierces near the... precise piece or something? It feels like a sturdy anchor. Okay, I guess we'll do that in a minute. Bet he fell. He's down there. He probably wants to go and get his body. As you reach the edge of the bluff, you recognize the exact location from your vision of the of Pescara. He was here not long ago, and he's fallen, hasn't he? Saren stands alert, Arden statue in one hand, while the she scans the cliff. You close your eyes, feeling the ether for some trace of Pescara's presence. The darkness behind your eyelids takes shape. You feel Pescara, yeah, I'm botching these names, running through the forest, this time hurtling and dashing around rocks and trees. The scenery whizzes by too fast. You can't make out the details between the blurred greenery. Something looms out of the trees ahead of you. Pescara finally stops in front of the Ardent Arc. Seriously. I know where to look next for Pescara. Do you recognise it? A natural arc made of Arda. Yet you get no response. I know where to look.
Then I'll follow.
Not slowly.
In these visions, I don't suppose you're getting a sense for who Persak is now.
Someone who appreciates the scenery. I get a sense of someone who's bold, adventurous, and still a leader of the Kith. Chuckles. Nothing against these stuffy forests, but you haven't seen the southern lights of Nova.
At least we're getting closer.
Shrugs.
Seems like we've made more progress together than I've made in a year.
And you've also been sitting at my place for how many weeks, months in game time? What was he like? Thought you knew Pescara.
I was just a child when he died. I remember fleeting images, but that doesn't mean much now.
Okay.
I talked to everyone in Masuk before I left. I heard that he was a strong leader, a dependable builder, a caring grandfather, a wise elder, a generous neighbor, a cunning negotiator.
She shrugs. Might as well be one of those impossibly perfect heroes from the Arcanth Adventures. Or Epic, sorry. He was probably all those things at different times. People remember the things about him that mattered most through time.
The odd thing is, many in Masuk weren't much older than me when Persak passed. And yet everyone wanted to make sure he heard about something in particular. Our trade with the Amawa. Our successful hunts. Peace with neighboring villages.
She keeps another pebble over the edge, follows its arc, her ears forward. Accomplished a lot that affects all of Moscow. He was obviously important to your people. No offense, she must have sent someone who knew him personally. It's obviously important to your people. Accomplished a lot.
It just seems odd that so few of us remember him beyond the things he did for the village. Most of his family members, the ones who knew him, are in their twilight years now. And Persak was too busy to spend much time with his younger relatives.
Yawns and patiently nuzzles her hand. I see. Seems like the legacy he left his family would be more important. He changed your village, that's worth remembering. Perhaps this is less about him and more about helping your village move on. Change your village.
Perhaps you're right.
Her brow creases, but the black paint obscures the look in her eyes.
Anyway, what about this Theos character you're searching for? Seems like he was someone important to you. What do you remember?
Very little. He was someone I trusted. I think he was an authority figure of some kind. He had an impressive beard. So trusted.
Not a lot to go on, eh? Hopefully you can pick up a few more clues about him while we're running around.
Enough chatter from me, or Pescara find himself a new body before we even get to this one. Wait, I need to discuss something else first. What's on your mind? I want to know about your homeland. Nazca. She rubs her nose with one broad finger. It's a big island in the middle of dead fire. Whatever that word is. Just off the coast of White that wends. Tundra mostly, with a few snow-covered forests in the warmer parts. Most of us live in fairly small villages by standards here. Anyway, mine is Nazca. What's Nazca like? Who lives there? What's Nazca like? She shrugs. Cold, but not as cold as White that weds. The few Keef who visit Nazca finds it sparse, but there's plenty of substance. A village if you know where to look. He ticks the items off on her callous fingers. We get hides and meat from Carabra, seals and small whales, bone too, which makes fine bows and arrowheads. Community is important to us. We survive or perish together. So everything we do, every week-long hunt, every wall we build is for the village. Who lives there? Mostly into tankics, like me. People here call us Burrow Dwarfs. Magmigrit? Clans of Glenfellan from the Whites and the Weds. Sometimes spend the Coda seasons on Naskek. But we don't see many other foreigners who can't tolerate the elements. She pats our weather bronze arm. Those of us born in Naskek like to say we have a hardy layer of seal skin just beneath our flesh. Tell me more about Muska. We're a tundra village. To an outsider's eyes, we're probably not much different from the others around us, but our elders have stories that go back hundreds of years, epic hunts, battles with neighbouring villages, sunjas across the sea, whatever that means, sunjars. We share these stories too. That is all. She nods. What do you do back in Naskek? I'm a long hunter. I stalk game across the tundra with some of the other wives. We usually hunt Calabra and Oxa, but we find hares and birds too. It's a good and respected position to see so much of Naskek in the company of my friends and sisters. This is one of the pleasures of life in Muska. Tell me about Ubika. She scratches behind his ear. Oh, it's the wolfy thing, isn't it? The little boy here. A good hunter, but not much of a talker, and that's been fine by me. When we hunt in Naskek, we almost always bring our foxes with us. They help us, a fox. They help us track and flush game. And they're fearless defenders against bears and snow leopards. Clever Umka has always been my favourite. He wags his tail, his brushly tail. You have a family back in your village? Of course. We'll never send a woman who hasn't had the chance to find a mate and have a couple of children of her own. You worried about your husband? Well, are you kidding? I'm the best shot in Muska. Tell me about your children. I've had 5, bloody hell. Yankon, Istra, Nach, again butchering these, Aklik and Malik. Istra and Aklik died young and long. Wow, lean winters, wow. Malik was barely talking when I left. She scrapes a thumbnail along the handle of her hunting knife. He probably won't know me when I get home. She frowns, her hand falling from her knife. Even in Naskek, I spent most of my time on the hunt. But then it's easier to relish the hunt when I know I'll see my family enjoying a kill. What's your husband like? Kalu's a good man. He's raised our children well and built us a strong home while I've been away on hunts. Our parents chose us for one another when we were still young, not the way things are usually done. But ours chose well. She smiles. We came to appreciate each other as helpmates first, then friends, and then, well, you know how it goes. There's a hint of blush below the stripes of her face paint. In other words, a little humpy getting on there, it seems. That is all. I'm curious about your search for Pascal. I'll tell you what I can, but Tarkan, Iskan, pilgrimage like mine are rare. Why do your people have this tradition? She pulls the bear figure out of her satchel, running a finger across its smooth back. It's something we've always done. The elders say it was first begun to forge ties with other villages. It's hard to fight over carbon herds when you see someone you respect on the other side. They also believe that passing our history on in this way keeps us stronger. And it helps them. The elders, I mean, return to us after they've been away from us for a generation or more. They can use the experience they've accumulated over a lifetime to lead the village again. Our elders usually reborn so far from the village. Most often they return somewhere in Naskek, a member of another village, or they're reborn among the Glamfellan of the Whites that weds. Even so, it's hard to say what's unusual. Our mistress Grin crinkles her eyes. When my grandfather was a boy, the elder came back as a polar bear. Okay. The huntress chosen for the task had to recite half of her village's deeds while running from the beast. Wow, I kind of feel that part was... I couldn't find the person, so I've just brought a polar bear. The person's in here. Yeah, I've packed on my ritual. Okay, that makes me remind me of Lost for some reason. You know, program Lost. I think I watched one episode of that in my entire life, and I thought it was horrible. It made no sense. And I think I actually voted polar bear on a desert island or something. I was like, what the hell's going on? I just, put it aside after that episode. The expression, sober. Sobers, even so, they have been journeys longer than mine. Some last decades, and the huntress doesn't always return. What happens when the elder is found? That depends on the man or the woman he's become. It's easier when the rebirth happens in another village or Nazca, where tradition is understood. Even in the white that the webs in the southern islands or Deadfire, Arca, whatever, people understand this custom and will welcome you politely enough, even if their souls do not remember. She shrugs, but sometimes you find someone whose soul has no memory of the village, and you have to tell him of people who remember him still. Disheartening as this is, you hope that the rememberer will aid his soul in a future life. How did you get picked to come search for Puska? She grins, another old village tradition. The elders watch the carbon migrations and cast seal bones to determine the right time for this journey. When the omens were determined, all the village wives drew sharp teeth. We're the ones that go away to hunt and fish, so we're the best suited for tasks like this. Anyway, I grabbed the little tooth. She frowns. Travelling so far is a rare privilege for us, but as you can see, the journey can be unpredictable. Okay, move on. And I feel we have to go down here. We're at 60 minutes, so we'll actually go down next episode. So please like, please subscribe, share this time. I've been Abdul, you've been awesome. Thank you for watching. Please put a comment and subscribe. See you next time. Bye, buddy.